Today, we take a look at SVG logos, how to create one and then add it to your Divi site to make pixel-perfect logos and images every single time. And we'll even take a look at how to manipulate some of the code to customize that logo and do some awesome things. Let's go. Welcome guys, Roby here with the Divi Engine team with another Divi tutorial for you, taking things a little bit further and delving into creating SVG logos. Now, what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be recreating this logo in Adobe Illustrator and then export that image and upload it to our Divi site and utilize a plugin, super easy to use, SVG support, that's going to enable SVG images on your Divi site. Now we're going to look at that method, and then we're going to look at one more method where we utilize the code, the SVG code that this image generates, and how to manipulate different aspects of that, because in a future tutorial next week, we're going to be looking at animating our logos or hamburger icons or whatever it might be to achieve some awesome results. So why don't we just hop right into it and start in Illustrator. Alrighty, so we're going to get started here in Illustrator, and I am going to recreate this for you. So we're going to go to File, and then we'll just say New Illustrator Image. Now I'm using a size of 400 by 100 pixels. At the end of the day, this is just arbitrary because you can have the actual export or save file conform to the actual content in there. But let's go ahead and create this new image. Now we're going to get started by selecting the circle tool, and I'm holding down shift so that it creates it nice and uniformly like this. Now, if I don't do that, it will create, you know, can create an ellipse like that, but that's not what we want. That's not what we're doing. So I'm going to go ahead and I want to fill this with just black. And there we go. So now we have the first part of our logo done here. I'll make it a little bit larger so it kind of fits right in here. Bam. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, so next up, we need some text. Actually, let me make this just slightly smaller. We need that text in there, so we're going to go select the text tool, and then I'm just going to type in my logo. Now, you can type in anything in here. This is more of a demonstration of how to do this. So definitely let your imagination flow. So I'm going to select my text here and I am going to type in Poppins because that's the font I'd like to use. And I'm going to use the extra bold version of the font. And then we're going to do the same as we did earlier. I'm going to press the Control T button to open up the transform settings. Well, first select it. And then I'm going to hold that shift button and make it much larger. So get that nice and big. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag it over so I can kind of start seeing this MY part sticking out over the edges. And that's that. So next up, we're just going to go ahead and select those first two letters, the M and the Y, and we'll change the full color to white. And there we go. And this is kind of the aesthetic that I'm going for. If we look at my original one, that's kind of what it looks like. And we have something similar here. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to convert this text into a path. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on type. And then from there, we're going to go and click on create outlines. Now that converts this whole thing into individual letters. Now you can see that if I click on one letter, it selects all of them. We right click that and we just say ungroup, and that will make it individually selectable. And that is what we want here. So now we're almost done here. Next up, we are going to select our circle and the MY. And then what we want to do is we want to go to the window. And then we want to click on Pathfinder. Now we need to go ahead and combine these two. Now it really depends on what you're doing. Like if you wanted to do some sort of animation where you're changing the individual colors of the letters, you wouldn't do this step, but I just want that to be like a black circle with the MY kind of cut out. And for that, I think I need to go and click on the minus front. And there you can see now, this is no longer those objects, it's one single object. And that's pretty much it. That's my logo done. So what I need to do, is click on File, and then I'm going to say Save As. Well, that'll bring up all this fun stuff, but I'm going to go here to Format, and I will just say SVG. I'm not going to use artboards because otherwise it would just, you know, select more than I need. And I will just give it a name, and I will just say my logo. And I'm just going to save it to my documents. That's fine. So hit the save button. Now I get a bunch of options here. You just want to make sure it's SVG 1.1. Type is SVG, of course. You want to embed any images. So if you had any images as part of your logo, this will embed it in the file so you're not running around looking for it. And then if you kind of look at the settings on my screen, that's what you want to see. Now, you're going to use this a little bit later here, but you see this SVG code button, and we're going to get to using that a little bit later. So I'm going to close that for now, and I'm just going to say OK. And now my logo is exported. So let's get into Divi and install the plugin so that we can get started by adding SVG images to our Divi site. Okay, now if you don't want a funky, disproportionate image, you can see all the white space here on the right-hand side. All you need to do is go in and select all the art, and then you're going to go to Object, and then you'll go to Artboard, and then you will say Fit to Artwork Bounds, and that will make it nice and tight like this, and that's what you're going to want. So I am just going to go ahead and resave this image, hitting Save, and now this is going to be perfect. So I'll see you in Divi in the next step. Okay, so here we are in Divi, and we need to install a plugin really quickly to get us rolling with utilizing SVG images in a Divi site. So all we need to do is go to Plugins, we're going to click on Add New, and then we're going to type in SVG support here, and that'll quickly think for a second, and then it's going to pull up this one right here, and that's the one that we're interested in. So we're going to click on Install Now. Okay, now with that installed, I'm going to click Activate. And that's really all there is to it. Now, when we look at the front end of our site, we can see that I've got the Divi Engine logo in there, and I have set that here in the theme options. And when I look at this image here, you can see that it's a PNG file. So I'm going to click on Upload. I'm going to select, and then I'm going to go to the My Logo SVG, open it, and you can see that it immediately reads the SVG file. You can see that it's a SVG right there. I'll set it as my logo, and I will go ahead and save it. Coming back to the front end, I refresh the page, and bam, I have my SVG logo up there. And this is going to be pixel perfect no matter what device, no matter what size I use this image as. And to prove that to you, let's quickly go edit the page, and then I'll add just an image, and I'll go select my SVG again, upload it, say that's okay. Yeah, we can already see that it's massive. And if I save the page, and then we'll go back to the front end, and yeah, you can see there it's nice and tiny, but it's nice and tight, and it's got very, very, very sharp corners. And the same thing here for this version of the image. You can still see that it's an image. Fantastic stuff. Now, I'm going to show you one more way that we can add this logo, but in a way that we can go ahead and manipulate different aspects of it, like maybe change the color of the L, the G, or whatever. And this is going to lay the ground for the next tutorial that we'll be doing, where we're going to show you how to animate these things. And it works really well with the new feature in Divi Mobile, actually, where we now fully support SVG hamburger icons. And this entire course is going to help you learn how to go ahead and create your own hamburger icons with their own unique animations. So let's take a look at how we set ourselves up for that by exporting the actual SVG code and using it on our Divi site. Let's go. Okay, so here I'm back in Illustrator. Now, you might not have Illustrator or have a paid membership to Illustrator. That's not a problem. There's another tool that you can use. It's super easy, and it's called InkScape. Now, InkScape is also a vector image editor that a lot of people choose to use if they don't want to, you know, spend the tons of money it is to have Illustrator. So another great tool to use, and I'm going to show you how to export the code in there also. So stick around. We're going to do that right after we do this method. Okay, so to get started here, we are going to go and just basically the same steps we did before. We're going to go to File, and we're going to go Save As. And we can give it a new name. We can use the same one. I'll just make it my logo one and hit the save button. But now here's where the difference comes in. We're not going to change anything here, but we will click here on SVG code. And as you can see, it spits out a whole bunch of code here in my text editor. Now we want to go ahead and copy everything here from the SVG tag down. Now the other stuff, that's just metadata telling you where this file came from and stuff like that. It's not really needed. So that is all we'll need. And then we'll jump into Divi yet again. But first, let me show you how to get this code if you built the logo using InkScape. Okay, so now here's the logo that I built out in InkScape as well. And the procedure is pretty much the exact same for building the logo. Now exporting, it's a little bit different. So here we're going to go to File again, and we're going to hit Save As. And here I'll have a bunch of different options. I'll just come here to my documents again, and we want to select optimized SVG. This is very important because it lets us customize some things on the next page. Okay, so here we have a bunch of different options here. You want to make sure that convert CSS attributes to XML attributes is selected. And then on the SVG output, you want to remove the XML declaration, the metadata, and the comments. That's all just a bunch of fluff that they throw in there. The rest of it's actually quite okay. And those are the only things you would do. You would hit the okay button. It actually goes ahead and saves the file. And then you just need to open it up in a text editor, which I will do right now. Okay, so here we have the text version or the code version that was spit out. And you will see here that it looks very, very, very similar to what was spit out by Adobe Illustrator. So you will copy that and then you'll pick it up from here and follow the same steps. Here we are back on the front end of my Divi site, and we're ready to add the SVG code to this page. So I'll just hit edit and I will go into visual mode because I want you to see this happening as I go through. I'll just delete this image here. And I'm going to hit the plus sign and I'm going to type in code because I need a code module because we're adding code. All we need to do is go ahead and paste that code in that we had generated. And there we go. We've got our logo right there. It's so easy to do. And let me kind of hook this onto the side there and give ourselves a little bit more room. Let's go desktop view. Lovely. Okay, guys. So now what I want to show you guys is how you can go about, you know, manipulating individual elements here on the screen. If you want to see what path leads to what element, you can just go ahead and kind of select one of those paths and break it. And you can see how on the side here, that little black bit popped away. So that is going to be that part of the path. Now, if I go down a little bit further, I can start identifying all my different letters here on the page. So this is going to be the L. So now just like with normal CSS, you can assign a class here to this element or to this path. So I'm going to say class equals letter dash L because I want that to relate to the letter L. And that's definitely not an L. There's an L. L for L. Okay. So then, you know, if we go and break this one, we see, okay, well, that's the O. So I can go class equals letter dash O. And I'm going to make this O1 because the wood logo, of course, has two O's. And then, you know, you can continue down with all the other letters. I'll just do the G also for posterity. Just confirm that's the G. And we'll go ahead and type in class equals letter dash G. And that's good to go. And that's really all we're going to do right here. Now, all these numbers that you see here relate to coordinates. That says where the curves and the lines go. That is a different lesson. And I'll link a detailed article on how you can manipulate that code also in the description of this tutorial, as well as in the article. But we're going to keep it semi-simple for this one. So I saved my code module. And now we just add another one. We type in code. And now we'll open up some style tags. So we're going to say style and open that up. Now what we're going to do, which is fun. I kind of get giddy about this. I'm going to select my class. So we're going to say letter dash L and open up curly braces. And we can have some fun here now. So what I'm going to say is fill, because we want to fill this element with a color. And I can say blue. And it turns blue. How awesome is that? And just finish that off with a semicolon. Now you can add something like stroke. And you can say black. And it will add a black outline to your text here. Now you can see how this can create some really interesting effects on your Divi sites. Fairly simply, we've written two lines of code basically, and we're completely changing the way this looks. Now, I'm not trying to make something that looks amazing or beautiful here, just something to illustrate how you could use this on a site and think about, you know, those animations that you might be doing in the next tutorial. Another thing I wanted to show you just also is that you can also do transform CSS on there, which we can maybe say, I don't know, rotate 3 degrees. And you see how it rotates it right there. Maybe we'll say -5. And that creates like a weird shuffled effect. And I think that's quite cool. Maybe you also want to say scale 1.2. And you make it a little bit bigger. But now, as you can see, that it kind of transformed it from a weird location. So let's say we're going to go transform. And we're going to say origin, colon, center, center. And that'll make it transform from the center of the element here. So you see, that looks much better. And it's just, you know, a really cool thing that you can do. And again, this comes into play a lot when you're going to start doing some animations with this stuff and other elements. Now, if we wanted to take it a bit further, we can add our letter G class that we created earlier. And, you know, let's make it easy. Let's go copy this code. We'll just paste it in there. And now we can see G even changed a bit. But for G, we want to kind of twist the other way. We're going to make it go down. We'll take the scale out for it. There we go. That looks pretty decent. And, you know, maybe we want to say something like translate X or Y, which is going to change the location. So let's say translate Y. And then I can say here 10 pixels. And that'll change, you know, where the actual item goes. So anyway, guys, this is a quick intro on how you can go and manipulate the CSS code. Oh, sorry, the SVG code on the page. I'm going to save this so we can see this on the front end of our site also. So let me open up that page here. And here we can see our different elements on the page. Really cool to be able to use SVG images and, you know, logo files. This is a SVG.SVG image. This is a SVG code. Now, you don't need the plugin installed to use the SVG code, as it is code. It will execute on a server that has that enabled. So fantastic stuff. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed this. I really get giddy about this stuff because it's really cool. And, you know, especially in the next part where we start animating things, you're going to be able to do some really cool stuff. And, you know, if you don't know yet, we've got our summer sale going on. This is part of that initiative to kind of teach you some really cool stuff with Divi. And as I mentioned before, Divi Mobile has SVG icons for the hamburger icon enabled now, so you can utilize these skills that you're learning here to make some awesome icons for your Divi Mobile menus on your Divi site. So that is right now 25% off. So definitely go check that out. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Definitely drop your comments below. We've got a huge raffle going on and all sorts of other good stuff. So definitely stay tuned for more great content here over the next couple of weeks as we kind of ride out this sale. And I look forward to bringing you more stuff. So guys, that was Roby with the Divi Engine team. I'm going to catch you guys in the next video. And don't you forget to hit that subscribe and like button for this video. That motivates us to keep doing this for you guys free of charge. So guys, catch you guys in the next video. Bye for now.